When we talk about fighter planes, we automatically think of sleek, agile aircraft like the military ones. Kalinin K-7 wasn't anything like this. More popularly known as the monstrous aircraft, its manufacture was not only successful, but it proved that any aircraft design which seems impossible to fly at first indeed, can soar high in the sky. In this video, we will cover every tiny detail surrounding the development and flight of the terrifying Soviet aircraft, Kalinin K-7, and the challenges protesting in between. When the globe was struck by two canon events, World War I and World War II, aircraft designers were busy scratching their heads trying to come up with transports that could carry hundreds of passengers across seas and oceans. To be specific, during the mid-1920s until the Second World War, aircraft manufacturers often entertained themselves by coming up with bizarre plane designs, which they knew were practically impossible to build. It was all fun and games until Konstantin Kalinin entered the scene, having already designed two massively successful aircraft, the K-4 and the K-5. Konstantin Kalinin had little or no idea that he would someday design the Kalinin K-7 for the world to lose its mind. The beast looked terrifying on the papers until it was manufactured. The ghastly aircraft could also be launched, but it faced equally large challenges and had a rough fate, if you ask us. So without any further ado, let's dive right into Konstantin Kalinin's passion for aircraft and his K-7 beast, an aircraft much ahead of its time, enough to leave you with goosebumps. Born in 1887, Konstantin Kalinin served a few good years being a part of the Imperial Russian Air Force during the First World War. Kalinin then became a part of the Bolsheviks in 1917, with the same role, continuing his aviation career. But designing aircraft wasn't his thing until 1925. Kalinin's growing interest in aircraft design resulted in a few of the most successful aircraft from the Soviets ending the two mono-wing airliners, K-4 and K-5. But during the late 1920s, he was busy secretly working on a bigger plan. The blueprint for a monster K-7 was already under his pen. All Konstantin feared was, will he ever get approval for such a substantial project? Considering it was Stalin at the helm, who often preached the idea of being an egalitarian, Kalinin was paranoid, fearing that if his plan did not work out, then the risks would be immense. Nonetheless, Kalinin proposed his idea, and Stalin grasped the military propaganda out of K-7, imagining the benefits it would present if the plan worked. So what was next? His blueprint was approved, and the administration started working on this Thunderbird in 1931. This massive production was completed after 2 years. By mid-1933, the first prototype of K-7 was ready. When we say massive, we mean it. The K-7 was 92 feet long, stood 40 feet tall, and even had a colossal wingspan of 174 feet. Its prototype broke several records, including having the largest wingspan area of roughly 4,800 square feet. For reference, it is straightaway double the length of an average commercial aircraft. Well, that's not all. The Kalinin K-7 was also the first aircraft to be supported by double tails. The wing's designs, elliptical dynamics to control airflow, and horizontal spans are considered one of the greatest engineering of the early 1930s. If the wings are impressive enough for you, then the weight of this interwar monster terrifies you. Having an empty weight of approximately 24,000 kilograms, the Kalinin K-7 weighed equal to 2.5 fully loaded Douglas DC-3 airliners. The manufacturers were dealing with such heavy machinery for the first time, so challenges were indeed inevitable. As you guessed it right, the K-7 required much advanced landing gears and assistance. Moreover, once fully equipped with a capacity of 120 passengers, and 7,000 tons of goods, the weight even exceeded the normalities. The K-7 was even loaded with 3 cannons in the forward firing position. The massive aircraft was already equipped with 6 engines, which was the most of any aircraft at that time. Alas, it required more engine power than that. So before its first ever flight, on August 11, 1933, the K-7 was loaded with another 2 engines in the rear side. Unfortunately, the aircraft could not handle the newly added rear engines and backfired. The pusher propeller at the back created extra turbulence, and the framework of the aircraft resonated with the vibrating engines. So during the test flight, it was confirmed that the flight aircraft was highly unstable. Not a lot of information was known to the manufacturers about resonance, as it was a newfound concept then. As a method to prevent the turbulence, the engineers shortened the tail and worked on the metal strength. The K-7 filled a few successful test flights following that incident and was deemed a successful invention. It was not only successful from a technological point of view, but was also a political victory, as all the steel used in the aircraft was produced by Russia itself. Unfortunately, on November 31st, when the flight was at a height of 350 feet, the right bomber separated and the plane dived, crashing on the ground. 15 out of the 20 onboard people were killed. Not a lot is known about the crash and no photo exists, all thanks to Stalin's secrecy propaganda. All that is known, the happiness of the K-7 was powerful but short-lived.